Dream, dream, dream. I'm chasing after you. I'm chasing after you. Whoa, dream, dream, dream. I know you can't come true. I know you can't come true. So I'm not gonna let you down. Someday I swear I'll win and wear that crown. So dream, dream, dream. I'm chasing after you. I'm chasing after you. So prepare to come true.
Fam, welcome back to my channel. We're all about love, positivity, being a girl boss, and everything in that vicinity. In today's video, we are doing a video about how to gain more traffic to your blog. You guys know I'm a blogger. That's one of my side hustles, one of the most important ones to me, and is one of my good little sources of income, and I love it to death. And since I have been talking more openly about that, you guys have been asking me questions about email lists and growing your blog and becoming a blogger, and I've gotten a lot of DMs lately. So I decided to go ahead and start creating more videos about blogging so that you guys can see how you can grow, and I can help, you know, some of you who are out here trying to become big bloggers out in these streets can, you know, be successful. If you're new to this channel, then go ahead and subscribe and turn on your notification bell so you don't miss any future girl boss videos. If you're not new to this channel, then welcome back. Thank you for being here. Thank you for loving me as much as I love you. And yeah, let's get straight into the video. So the first thing I'm gonna say as far as being a blogger is concerned is being consistent. Get yourself on a blogging schedule. Know when you're gonna post, what days of the week, what time, and schedule those blog posts. Bulk writing is important so that you guys can have scheduled posts ahead of time, and so that your audience can have something to expect, so that they know when you're gonna post, so they can go ahead and be like, okay, let me go check out her website because she's gonna have a new blog post up today. You want to make sure that you're not just sporadically throwing up blog posts. I know a lot of bloggers that do that, but it's just not a good look. It's also irresponsible, and it also allows people, it also makes people not really want to subscribe and consistently be looking at you, because they never know when your post is going to come out. And when people subscribe, it's because they like your content and they want more of it. And if they don't ever know that they're going to get more of it, or when they're going to get more of it, it's going to deter them from actually subscribing or actually looking to see when you're posting. Number two is utilizing Twitter. Twitter has a really good blogging community, in my personal opinion. It's the second best way of promotion to me. There's a lot of, you can use a lot of hashtag like bloggers tribes, and there's a lot of different comment threads, view threads. There's a lot of different threads where people are just in community supporting each other, giving each other advice, giving each other tips. They have some stuff like that on Facebook, but it's not nearly as deep and in-depth and open as it is on Twitter. Like on Facebook, you got to join groups, you got to do this, you got to do that. On Twitter, you don't have to do none of that. You can just go ahead and type in keywords bloggers, and you'll see all types of posts and tweets and everything else where bloggers are supporting each other, and you get a lot of good blogger advice and everything else. And so yeah, I definitely think that Twitter is a good move. Plus, you are more likely to have people see your stuff based off of keywords as opposed to them specifically knowing you and them already following you. Number three is use backtracks in your posts. So a good way to get more people, more views, more traffic to your blog and to your different blog posts is to link other blog posts in your post. For example, when I wrote my, if I write a blog post called How to Be Productive, and one of the things that I'm talking about is waking up earlier in the morning, because you guys know how I feel about both of those things, then I will use that blog post to link to other posts about waking up early in the morning around in that same paragraph where I'm talking about it, that same little blurb where I'm talking about it. I can add up a graphic that you can click on to go to a post about how to wake up in the morning, or my morning routine, or anything like that. And all of those will capture the interest and allow people to keep clicking. And when they, you keep having different stuff like that in your different blog posts, people would, for all you, people would just be clicking from blog post to blog post to blog post. And it keeps people spending more time on your website and more views on your individual blog posts. Next is to have an email list. An email list is important for retention, so that people who are very much interested in you and your brand will have a way to consistently keep track of your blog post and when you're posting, because they'll get an email notification so they don't ever miss it. So that in itself will allow you to have retention and allow you to have consistent views on your blog post. Email lists to me are the best way for bloggers in general to build their brand and make money from their blogging business. So an email list is really important. I'm going to get into more about email lists in another YouTube video. So if you guys are interested in that, then stay tuned, subscribe, and also let me know in the comment section down below if you're really interested in the email list videos, because I do have one or two that I am planning out right now. Next is to write less and promote more. Now, this is a personal opinion, something that I've noticed myself, and that is that if you spend less time writing content, consistently trying to throw out content as much as possible, and spend more time promoting and marketing and pushing out your content, you're going to find that you get a whole lot more done. Now, me personally, I do actually try to post 2 times a week, but if I don't post or if I don't upload, then I just do a lot more promoting. I believe strongly in doing 25% content creation and 75% content promoting, because there are millions of people out there online and you want to get as many of them as possible looking at your blog post. So if you're wasting your time writing more content instead of pushing out the value that you already have, the beautiful value that you've already written out to more and more people, then you are wasting your time and you're wasting your content. I feel like you could have more I would rather have content that lasts me the next 6 months than a plethora of content that only lasts me 2 months, because I'm just constantly spilling stuff out and it's getting and this content is getting drowned out by the other content, because I'm just like, oh, post this, promote it, post this, promote it, post this, promote it, instead of actually post this, promote, so that more people see what I have to offer and see the value before they just see that, oh, she posts every single day. Who is going to sit there and read all of that every single day? Next is to invite friends and family to read and share your posts. If your friends and family are really supportive, not everybody has a supportive friends and family, but for those of you that do, then getting them to read your blog post, sending them the link via text message, via email, via Facebook Messenger will also be a really good way to get people interactive and get more views on your blog posts and stuff like that. And you know, it's the same with YouTube. Get more of them to look at your stuff. Well, the next thing is working and spending consistent time on SEO. If y'all see this, my door is open because it's really hot outside, and I mean, it's really hot in here, and outside it's like cool, and so I'm trying to keep the door open so that I don't suffocate and die. So SEO is really important. It's search engine optimization. It's something that I only recently got into like in the past year or so, and it actually did make a huge difference with how many people are looking at my blog posts, because it got me ranking and whatnot in the Google search, and that is a big deal. So when people are looking up what you're talking about, your post will automatically show up. And so SEO is something that you really want to work on. And if you don't want to work on it, like me, then you should hire somebody, outsource somebody to do SEO for you. I am a strong believer in outsourcing and getting people to do the things that you do not enjoy and or are not good at. The next thing is to guest post and have other people guest post on your stuff. And that will help for 2 different reasons. One, when people are guest posting on your website, you will not have to worry about creating content, and you can focus more on the promoting and the marketing and things like that. And you're also helping out another person, so that's a fellow blogger that you guys are probably going to support each other in the future. And secondly, when they're promoting their blog post on your website, when people are clicking on that blog post, they're going to your site, not their site. And so then they'll be more likely to click on other posts, to click on other things, and that'll be a big upside, and it'll get more people on your website and more people to probably check out your stuff. And it's the same way if you're guest posting on somebody else's blog post, you're more likely to have people be like, oh, this is a really good blog post, I'm gonna go check out her channel. Or not her channel, I'm gonna go check out her blog. So that's a really good way to get more views to your blog by guest posting on somebody else's and by allowing somebody else to guest post on yours. Number 9 is to utilize Pinterest. Pinterest, my ladies and gents, is the biggest form of blog traffic for me. And if you don't know anything about Pinterest, I would suggest that you get to learning. It is going to be a lifesaver, and it also is a good way to get passive traffic to your blog, because all you got to do is get a Tailwind account and utilize that. And once you utilize it, you will see the difference. I promise that you will see the difference if you are actually using it right. And in order to learn more about that, there is an affiliate link in my subscription box below about how to utilize Tailwind and use Pinterest for your blog and to get more traffic that way. So if you guys are interested in learning about that, it's not expensive at all. I think it's like $15, $20 or $10 or something. And it's a course on how to utilize Tailwind to grow your blog and how to use Pinterest. And it talks about how to create pins. It talks about how to make it goals. It literally breaks it down for you step by step by step. So if blogging is something that you're really interested in and you're really interested in getting that boost of traffic, then I would suggest that you look into Tailwind. And if you really want to learn about Tailwind, then I suggest that you go in the suggested links and look for the Pinterest course. 10, last but not least, is to be authentic. Be your authentic self. It does not make any freaking sense to be out here trying to It does not make sense to be out here trying to be a carbon copy of somebody else. Their subscribers are already subscribed to them because they like them. You want your own audience, your own tribe to like you for you. And in order to do that, you have to be yourself. So allow your personality to come through. Allow things that you like to see on your blog, because your tribe will like to see it as well. So pay attention to that. Don't just be out here just putting out stuff because you think, oh, she writes like that, her format is like that, so I should do the exact same thing. It's okay to be inspired by other bloggers, but it's not okay to just be a carbon copy of another blogger. Nobody else is you, so be you. That goes for YouTube, that goes for blogging, that goes for your business, that goes for everything that you do to me, because I feel like my tribe, the people that are for me, who find me, are gonna love me as I am because of my own little personality. You feel me? So yeah. So those are my 10 tips for how to get views to your blog posts. If any of these you found helpful, if you have any extra tips of your own, then leave them in the comment section down below. These are all things that have worked for me, that I have done, that I have utilized, and I'm not sharing them just because I heard somebody else say them. Although I have heard other people say other things. I've heard people say that Twitter is not good, so you know. Whatever. But if you found this helpful, if you guys are excited to see more stuff about email lists, more blogging, then let me know, because I want to know exactly how many people are actually excited, if I'm gonna have to like dedicate a whole nother day to post about blogging stuff. I just need to know how you guys feel about that, or if you know, just every now and again posting something about blogging works. Let me know if you're a YouTuber and a blogger, then that might be informational to you, because I've been blogging a lot longer than I've been doing YouTube. So yeah, leave all that in the comment section down below. If you have anything you want to add, then go ahead and add that. If you have any questions, then go ahead and add that, and I will either go ahead and answer you or create an entire YouTube video dedicated to you and your question. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you've made it to this point in the video, then leave a ruler emoji in the comment section down below. I love you guys so much. If you're not following me on social media, follow me on social media, cherishingflow_ on Twitter, cherishingflow_ on Instagram, cherishingflow on Twitter, cherishingflow on Pinterest, all those good things, and I will see you guys in the next video.